from a dumpy little office in West Covina, California, it's the Foos Show! Hey, what is up, everybody? I am Joe C.
And I'm Jess.
And thank you all very much for listening to the Foos Show. Thank you for downloading the pod on most major podcast apps, subscribing, and telling a friend like a champ. You can always reach us at Foos Show. That's fwobarshow.com. And fwobarshow is our handle on Facebook, Tumblr, Twitter, and Instagram. Check us out, drop us a line, and we'll foo it up like a couple of foos. Ain't that right, foo?
I'm so hard. I have no idea what's going.
What's up, everybody? Happy Halloween. We are recording this on Halloween day, evening, mid-afternoon.
Dusk.
Yeah. On tap today, we have Steph.
What's up, my dudes?
Hi, Steph. Thanks for joining us. Mainly, we're gonna try to make this one quick, kind of like we did for the last time. I just want to maybe shed light on a couple things you've been noticing. Maybe the some of the more recent episodes have been a little different lately. There's just been little time to get shit done.
Yeah,
I've been trying to buy a house
And succeeded, mind
yes,
you.
Yes, I got a house.
Congrats for Josie
people. Steph and I will be moving very soon eastward of here, so we'll be doing it from an adequately decorated office in Ontario, California.
Adequately? Why don't we just do it in that sunroom, man? Just in a dinky little sunroom in Ontario.
We're going to change our entire image.
Yeah. Change the whole format.
But
levels.
I think as soon as we get the rest of the year done here at the dumpy little office, we're going to be migrating this setup to Ontario. Mm-hmm. Josh will still be a part of it as far as we know.
Yep.
The foo might make some appearances from time to time. He'll be a little further.
He may have to communicate in.
Yeah, he'll phone it in. He'll do what he's been doing this whole time, except this time he'll literally be phoning it in.
Whoa.
One thing we wanted to highlight today, and it's fun that it's Halloween. You know, we're excited to pass out candy to all the neighborhood kids a little later on tonight.
No, you're not.
No, we're not.
You mean I have to answer the door?
But you're the one, you're the nice lady who's giving away.
Yeah, the nice lady with an alien sticking out of her chest. Yeah, that's exactly how you want to greet a child. You guys are the worst.
No, we're not.
Kids should not be. Keep your children away from these people.
Hey, look, I bought some good treats for them. Okay, Costco was selling a package of Twinkies.
Costco knew what was up.
And cupcakes.
Yep.
Just for the special occasion.
Yes, but
they're
hybrids. I heard there's going to be a zip code screening, though, prior to the handing out of such.
Say
Twinkies.
What?
This is your words yesterday, not mine, man.
Not a zip code. There's an age range. Okay, you have to be between 5 and 7.
Oh, damn.
Yeah, otherwise no candy.
5 and 7.
So that means they're
nice
gonna
crisp
high they're five. Gonna come right at dusk.
You
so.
Want a penny? There you go. You just earned 1 cent on your visit. You're a winner.
Right.
Shoo shoo.
So we're gonna be doing that. One thing we wanted to highlight was our previous trip to LA Comic Con.
Oh my god!
This last weekend we went on Saturday. I wore what I'm wearing now.
Yeah.
Those who aren't fortunate enough to check this out live on Facebook, I'm dressed as SNL's David S. Pumpkins,
and he does a terrible impression.
I do a terrible impression. All right, you ready? You ready? You want to hear it?
Yeah. Let's go.
How's it hanging? I'm David S. Pumpkins. Any questions?
That's actually a great David S. Pumpkins radio voice.
Yeah.
You guys are terrible.
You guys are terrible. Pissing off Josh now. Anyway, I've already gotten the food bar started earlier today, so excuse me if I start slurring.
David S. Pumpkins.
I'm David S. Pumpkins. Any questions?
All right. So, and Josh, you're not wearing a goddamn thing now because you didn't wear a goddamn thing when we went to the LA Comic Con.
I stayed consistent.
And actually, Steph, you weren't wearing what you're wearing now, where you have an alien popping out of your chest. You were Death?
I was Death from DC Vertigo Sandman comic.
Uh-huh.
And it's pretty much just goth girl with black lipstick.
That's all it was in a top hat.
Yeah.
Just a normal day then?
Oh, yeah, pretty much.
Okay. Yeah. On Halloween, she dresses normal.
It's going to be her new name in the Facebook chat, Death.
Death.
That's right.
I used to do face paint And at the end of the day, it just gets really sticky. And
that's why I did not want to go through the rest of my costume. I was like, oh, dude.
The only other thing other than wearing this suit is me painting the stripe on my hair.
Yeah, but that's nothing.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, it was spray painted on, really.
Wow, how long did that take you?
It took me all of better part of 2 minutes, I think.
Really? Because you
got to shake the can. I clock in as soon as I pick up the can, you know.
Oh, yeah,
and then I got to shake the can and then do the thing.
I'm looking at the makeup job with the spray, and it actually looks like a perfect line.
Well, I did it on my part, because my hair parts right here, so I did it right on the part.
Right, but it looks like you actually covered up the hair that you didn't want, instead of just, like, freehanding it.
Oh, got it. Well,
like a stencil.
Maybe next Halloween there, Steph.
You know what? Yeah, it does look like you're putting on a line on a soccer field or something.
That's funny.
It looks perfect. It's a perfect line.
Are you just laying down when they're setting up the field? Like, all right, stop me off right there, buddy.
I went to the local high school here, and I just laid down for 5 minutes while they ran by with the line-making thing. Yeah. Thanks for that, Steph.
You're welcome.
I'll never unsee it. I got stopped a lot over at Comic-Con. It was a good time because a lot of people recognized the David S. Pumpkins. I actually ran into a David S. Pumpkins, too.
Yeah, and I guess there was a third one there, too.
Yeah, that we never met. But before we start stepping on the segment, anything else you guys wanted to get out of the way that you guys have been up to aside from LA Comic-Con before we get on with it? Or we're pretty good to go here.
Let's just go, man.
Well, we took the Foo Bar microphones over at LA Comic-Con. Check it out.
Foos on the run. Foos on the run. When the day is done, let's have some fun and yell at everyone. For the Foos on the run. Foos on the run.
All right, everybody. I am Josie. I'm here at the LA Convention Center for the LA Comic Con. Say what's up, Josh.
What's up, Josh?
God damn it. Okay, so what have we seen so far, man?
Some crazy-ass cosplay going on here. We saw a Vegeta, Bulma, and a little mini Super Saiyan Blue Goku. There was a bunch of Spider-Man taking pictures. A
lot of Spider-Men, yes.
There was a Storm that looked like, you know, she went through some troubles. But, you know, not that I'm judging or anything. You know, nothing wrong with that. Yeah, man, it's been crazy stuff. I saw a Ness from Supernatural carrying around a bat.
Right, yeah, we saw this guy dressed as Ness. Actually, he's right in front of us walking over there. Yeah, we just went to one of these, was it Cleveland-style Reuben types of food trucks?
Like they had Reubens. I just had a maple bacon fries, which were amazing, by the way, or sweet potato fries.
I had the bacon mac and cheese fries. Those things were very filling. I didn't even finish it, so.
Too much for it. I mean, they give you your money's worth for sure, but.
And Josh, you got one of these mystery boxes. What did you? I saw that you opened it up. What was in there?
It's just like a bunch of little collectibles, like little Dragon Ball Z collectibles. There's a stuffed plush Master Ball from Pokemon, and then there's like this little pop toy from. Secret Life of Pets, the crazy rabbit that Kevin Hart plays.
Oh, crazy.
Yeah, so I'll probably give that away to my little nephew and such. But yeah, some pretty cool stuff in here. It was like $40. Like all this stuff's worth $100, so it was a nice little mystery box. They had other stuff too, like a big NES controller box.
All right.
Yeah, and I believe they also had like the 1-Up Mario box too. Like with the little question mark.
And that had like Mario types of toys in there?
Probably, yeah. I think each box, depending on what the outside is, has that same element inside. So it's all mystery stuff. You could probably get a big thing or a bunch of little shit like I did.
That sounds pretty dope, man. So I hear that we missed Tenacious D. That was supposed to be yesterday, right?
Yeah, Tenacious D was on Friday. They were the last ones to be on main stage because they also premiered. They premiered their post-apocalyptic animated show.
That's right. Yeah, they're coming up with that new show.
Yeah, they had the screening last night, so. Yeah, I mean, unfortunately, we missed that, but there's some good stuff going on. Elijah Wood's going to be here tonight.
Oh, shit, for what?
He's going to be showcasing his movie Mandy that Nicolas Cage is in. It's like a horror movie.
Oh, crazy, okay. Yeah. Is he producing it?
He's producing it, and I think he wrote it.
Okay, nice.
Yeah, so we're going to see that. Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. was just on before we got here, and then we're also going to see, for those of you who are Flash and Arrow fans... Black Canary and Black Sirens. Katie Cassidy, she'll be here.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. So you ready to get inside, man? Because it's hot as a motherfucker.
It's hot as balls out here. So we'll see if we report anything else later.
What's up, my dudes? So Fanguru is hosting a scavenger hunt for this year's LA Comic Con, and my friend Christine and I have been partaking in the scavenger hunt. Pretty much what you do is you download the app, it gives you directions, and you have to take a picture with a group of cosplayers, a horror film character.
Horror films?
Horror. I don't know, a bunch of other stuff too. And the last picture we need is a picture with the Hulkbuster, and that is the
big Iron Man suit, right?
The big Iron Man suit that, ironically, Banner actually wields himself in the Avengers movie.
Instead of just turning into the Hulk.
Right, because he can't. So we have yet to find it, and we can't take a picture with a toy. We have to take a picture with a full life-size replica.
Oh, crazy. Is that supposed to be around here somewhere? Like, you just got to locate it?
We have been looking for it, and we cannot find it. So we're thinking,
is it mobile?
We don't know. It's either a statue or somebody's actually cosplaying as a Hulkbuster.
Interesting. So when you finish the scavenger hunt, what do you expect to win?
It just says come back to their booth and collect your prize. So I don't know. We might get a nice hat or, you know, crisp high five. We don't know.
All right. Well, we'll keep on walking to see what kind of shenanigans we can get ourselves in. All right. Well, here we are back in the break area. I think we're waiting for some of our friends to get something to eat. But God damn it, Josh, you bought a shitload of stuff. So there's these mystery boxes that everybody's all into.
Well, a few of the mystery boxes, again, like I had said previously, one of them was in the shape of Dragon Balls. You know, they had the Dragon Ball design and the stars. Others had one-up boxes for Mario. There's a big NES controller, and each of them are supposed to have a bunch of mystery items, either based off of the box itself or just random. So one of the boxes...
But you got, like, two more.
I got, like, three. I got, like, three total. Yeah. I kind of went out of control, but...
One of the highlights, too, was a pipe that you bought in the shape of Thanos. The guy pretty much had you sold when he said what?
The gentleman said, yeah, he'll get rid of half of your weed.
And that sounds about right. At least half.
Thanos is very fair when it comes to your ganja. So, you know, at least you know you'll still have half left.
Right. So.
That was pretty cool. Like, that whole little setup they had over there, it was called, like, edibles, and they had a lot of CBD types of edibles and things. That was pretty interesting, wasn't it, Jesse?
Yeah, it was. It was pretty dope. They had different kinds. Like, I really liked the Bowser one that they had. It was like a pipe. And they had other kinds of superheroes. Every pipe had, like, a little theme to it.
They had a Hulk. They had a Hulk one that looked pretty cool. But as soon as I saw that Thanos one, I just like, okay, all right, that's it. Game changer.
Word.
They even had, like, this long Gandalf style of pipe, but it was, like, rubbery.
Yeah, the guy said that it would never break, which is awesome because I remember stepping on one of those and it cut my foot open. Yeah, that was yours, you dick. Yeah. I know.
You gotta know that I keep everything around me booby trapped.
Yeah, that was fucked up. Anyway, so...
you've actually been quite popular here at Comic-Con. Everyone seems to be pulling you aside like David S. Pumpkins. But I'm still saying you're missing the greatest opportunity to really lean into it. You're never saying, any questions?
I don't think there's ever an opportunity to say it so far. Well, there's been one.
There's only been one, but I will give you the benefit of the doubt that you were extremely high at the time.
Yeah, no thanks to you.
Hey, I'm sorry. Are we not here to have fun?
No, this is America. You're right.
Oh, this is America. This is not America. Oh, this is America. Oh, yeah. But...
What's, like, the most exciting thing you got? I saw that you got, like, a comic book. You got a few t-shirts. You got some pops, figurines.
One of the most exciting things I got so far was a Dragon Ball Z figure, an actual, you know, action figure. for Mystic Gohan, which is Goku's son. Just as strong, and it's pretty cool.
Nice.
Got a lot of Goku, got a lot of anime stuff. That Aki Bento box, which was amazing, all the stuff that was in it. I found a Goku Black Pop toy, which is very rare to find, and I was the only one out of all the three of us that purchased it, Steph and Christine included, that actually got it. So it was pretty cool. It's pretty cool stuff.
Dope, man. Well, I don't know how much longer we're going to keep walking around. I'm sure we don't want to catch another... I'm sure we don't want to miss, I mean, another baseball game. We got the Dodgers playing.
We got another 18 innings that we got to watch.
Jesus Christ. Last night was a fucking... It was killer. Oh, man. Yeah, it's like we were watching two different games. I mean, by the end of the game, you forgot that Bueller had started pitching.
Yeah, you forgot Bueller had pitched a gem, mind you. A gem. No runs. With seven Ks, seven strikeouts?
Yeah, but the bats were dead.
Yeah, both sides, though. That's the good thing. Like, at least we quieted down the Red Sox bats, because they were just fucking raping us in Fenway Park.
Yeah, it was weird, man. At least it was, good weather to play baseball yesterday here in Los Angeles.
Yeah, you know, it was around 90. It's going to be around that today, I believe.
Pretty bright outside as we are. I mean, we're outside of some food trucks right now where everybody's just hanging out.
There's a nice breeze coming through, though, so that's kind of helping. It's much cooler inside, but it's just so crowded.
It's really crowded in there, and I think they're getting set up for another panel coming up that everybody seems to be excited about. I haven't seen the schedule yet, but we saw one of the most exciting people I saw so far. Well, we saw the Red Ranger and the Yellow Ranger from the old school Rangers, Power Rangers.
We saw Michael Biehn.
Michael Biehn was there. Danny Trejo, Machete himself.
Was in a Rams jersey, mind you. Jared Goff, Rams jersey and Rams hat. So that guy's ready.
He's ready. Yeah, that guy, he's ready for it. So awesome, man.
Yeah, man. So, we'll obviously recap this more as we come back, as we get back home into our dumpy little office. But it's been great so far. It's just goddamn packed. It's like Disneyland times 10 in a sardine fucking can.
Yeah, and the cosplays are pretty impressive here, too. I've been checking out a lot of these creative cosplays that I'm seeing around here. And have you seen any ones that stood out to you so far?
There was a Power Rangers Venom, like, cosplay.
A Black Power Ranger, right?
A Black Power Ranger that was, like, as if Venom had took over him, which was pretty cool. That was a pretty interesting take.
Yeah, I saw a Deadpool Stormtrooper.
Oh, yes, I did see him too. There was a family running around here dressed as the Bulma, Vegeta, and Goku.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
Yeah, and it was pretty cool too because the guy had long enough hair to where he put it up almost like Vegeta's, so that was cool. There's a guy that's dressed around here like Kratos from God of War with an axe, and he just straight up yelled in the middle of the entire place. Like,
yeah, it was crazy. One of the ones that have stood out is this guy in a really convincing Captain America holding up a sign that said Trump is Hydra.
Yeah, that's great. He's just walking around with the sign, posing with the sign. It's cool. I actually saw a Spider-Man Iron Man like crossover. Like,
that's pretty dope.
Yeah, the Shield had the spider sign over it on the back. And it was like he's just all like Captain America'd out, but he's in a Spider-Man suit.
That's crazy.
From scratch. Like, a lot of these cosplays are great because you could tell a lot of people put a lot of detail and work into them.
Yeah, when it comes down to it, when you have a proper cosplay that's almost to the T, as far as what the what it was when you saw the movie, I mean, they probably invested around $500 on something like that at least.
Yeah, especially some of these guys that dress up as like Star Wars characters. They are selling some lightsabers here, and they're actually like battle ready. Like, you can actually smack them and fight with them, which is pretty crazy. But it's like $100 to $300, depending on the lightsaber you want.
Wow. Well, I like lightsabers, but I don't love lightsabers that much.
if I can beat the shit out of somebody without going to jail, then yeah, I like lightsabers.
And make it sound and look somewhat cool.
Yeah. Like, boom, boom, give me your money, boom, boom.
All right, man. Well, we're going to have a quick snack, and then we're going to walk around for a little bit and then maybe get home in time to watch the first few innings of that Dodger game. So
try and beat the traffic from out here. I know it was crazy last year when we tried to leave. We actually waited, another extra hour, Steph? We waited an extra...
Yeah, about an extra hour just to get out of the parking lot and onto the freeway.
So we may think about leaving, I would say maybe an hour and a half. 2 hours early. Yeah, it's been fun. Great. Definitely advise everyone that can come out next year. Definitely look into it. Tickets usually go on sale in like August, July. So always look out for it, guys.
Sweet, man. All right. Well, back to us in the studio, I guess.
The studio.
Yeah, the studio.
How fucking high were you still? Jesus.
I was pretty high, man. one thing to get out of the way for everybody listening. Do you shop on Amazon? Would you like to support the show? Go to foobarshow.com. That's foobarshow.com. At the bottom of the homepage, click on the Amazon banner, bookmark it on your browser, and do your regular Amazon shopping from there. Doesn't cost you anything, and you're supporting the show. So, Josh, what'd you think of fucking LA Comic Con after that whole recap?
Dude, it was great, with the exception of having to wait outside for your food to be done, Steph.
Let's put them on blast for a
second. That was a fucking nightmare. That was called
the New York Delicatessen Truck.
So tell everybody what happened, Steph.
Look, this is what I was trying to avoid from the last year that I went. What happened is I get to the front of the line. There was like almost no wait to order.
Yeah.
So I get to the front of the line. He's just like, okay, just to let you know, it's going to be a 45-minute wait. And we're out of burgers. So I got a veggie burger. I can put pastrami on it. And I'm just like, you know what? I'm looking around. There's like three other food trucks. And
they all have big lines.
They all have big lines just to order. Yeah. So I'm already at the front of the line. I'm just like, you know what? Fuck it. I'm starving. It's already like 2:33 o'clock.
There, Steph.
So I'm just like, okay, you know what? Just give me a veggie burger and some sweet potato fries. That's it. Two things.
Fucking gross.
Hour and a half.
Yeah, dude.
Later. Yeah, that was fucking starving. It's
yeah,
like
you
4:30.
You were pissed.
It's 4:30 in the afternoon, and it's not just me. It's everybody else in line. And so there was this one guy who just kept coming up. He's like a couple of numbers ahead of me. And he's just like, just check in to see if you guys got my order yet. It's like, oh, okay, no worries. You know, I'll just wait. I'll come back.
He's being all nice about it.
Right? Yeah. That was the first time he asked.
Cordial as fuck.
And so each time that he came back, he's just like, look, I've been here for an hour and a half. I'm hungry. I got shit to do. Okay, where's my food?
Mm-hmm.
It's like, look, I'm thinking to myself, guy, don't make the staff angry. They're just going to work slower. And then you're going to ruin it for the rest of us. Just suck it up. We're all waiting.
Yeah.
Oh my god,
this guy's just like, nope!
Not only that, but it's fucking expensive! $27 for those two items.
Yeah.
Fuck, that was bullshit.
Hour and a half wait, and the food tasted like shit.
I was like, Steph, is that the best burger you've ever had?
No.
She's like, negative.
No, like, and that, sometimes I eat veggie burgers because I like the taste. You know, I'm not a vegetarian or whatever. But
said no one ever.
It tastes good to me.
Yeah, it's fine.
Oh, this was terrible. It was just horrible. Ugh.
Even the sweet potato fries weren't even that good.
No.
It wasn't that good.
They were a little undercooked.
The shit we had, though, was actually pretty bomb.
But anyway,
you guys did it right. You guys ate early.
Oh, we ate early, and that's how I recommend doing it moving forward.
Yes.
I went in there with a little bit of an appetite. I didn't really have a huge breakfast, but I went in there. I attacked the food trucks, and we got the fuck out of there.
Oh, yep. We got out of there.
The sun was beating down, too.
We were solid up until we were stuck in the sun for a while.
Yeah, waiting for your food.
Waiting for your food. And I think that exhausted us more, because I mean, my legs were pretty tired, but like the sun beating down on me when I was sitting there, I'm just like, all right, I'm ready to take a nap. Like,
but while that was happening, I took another lap around Comic-Con and met with some very interesting characters. A lot of people wanting to take pictures with David S. Pumpkins.
Yeah.
And
everyone that's the David S. Pumpkins, any questions? They said it better than you.
Yeah, I remember.
Everybody beat me to it. That's why I never really had a chance to say it. It's because everybody would approach me with, any questions?
Because you were.
And I'd be like,
you were in the mentality, man. You got to be in the mentality.
No, you know what it was? You know what it was?
What?
It was probably all that fucking weed that you provided
Don't you put that on the weed. Don't you put that evil on the weed.
I have to. That makes me sound like a fucking maniac if I don't, right?
That's true. It's true.
It's funny. At one point, we were waiting for Josh because I think we were checking out something.
Yeah.
And somebody comes up to Josie and he's just like, David S. Pumpkins, that's the most annoying character ever. And then he just walks away.
Oh, yeah. I'm just like, well, you got that one in, bro. Yeah, go for it.
Thanks.
For
it. Yeah. Thanks a lot.
I hope that made his day.
Right?
It's nothing like an angry nerd, you know?
The
one that's like not aware of, you know, how other people really care about things. The one that just like, this is my opinion.
I hate it.
I hate
you
it.
Suck. Bye.
I'm out of here.
Those are the worst.
I know.
What was your highlight, Steph? I saw that you took a lot of pictures with a few characters.
The Deadpool that I took a picture with sounded exactly like
You were saying
Ryan Gosling.
Ryan Reynolds.
Ryan Gosling?
Hey, girl.
Hey, girl.
Is that what he said?
The wrong Ryan, but I'll be a Ryan. sounded exactly like him. And so I did a double take. I was like, no. In hindsight, I was looking at him. He's just a little too short.
Yeah. Because you obviously know how tall Ryan is.
I know how tall he is. I know what he looks like. Oh, my God.
Fucking fangirl. Anyway, continue.
But it wasn't just me. Christine also took a picture with him.
Christine's excited about anything and everything. So.
Yeah. Christine's like a little puppy.
I know.
Yeah. Her best friend, Christine, is just excited about everything she encounters. She
loves it.
Great.
And that's just out. That's just anywhere. We're not even like. Whoa, it's not even LA Comic Con.
When we were together, when we were by ourselves, when we lost you guys, we came across the. They had the Ghostbusters car there, and she's just like, "Aww." I was like, great. "God damn it,
Jesus
Christine.
Christ!"
You can picture her in anime with like the big teary eyes.
Yes, exactly. That's the big googly
exactly
eyes.
What Christine is. She's an anime character.
Aww. Other than that, there were some pretty good looking horror characters. Texas Chainsaw Massacre. There's a couple Jason.
There's some Michaels.
So yes.
The Michaels.
A lot of Michaels. Oh,
and then I took a video of Slash, not the real Slash, but you know, cosplay Slash.
With a guitar.
With a guitar.
It's functional
amp. And a little amp attached to his belt playing the Michael Myers theme song, or the Halloween theme song.
Oh, in front of Michael Myers. Yeah, I saw that post. That was scary.
And he's there every year, that cosplayer, Slash. He's there every year.
Really?
Nice. Yeah. Okay. Nice. I saw that at the end of the Halloween theme, he switches his knife to the other hand and uses his main hand to shake the hand of Slash.
Yes.
For playing his theme song for him. Thank you, Slash.
The one person he won't kill.
He won't kill Slash.
No.
It was Slash and Slasher. Yep. Anyway. What about you, man? What did you like about Comic-Con?
Oh, dude. There was a lot of shit there. It was pretty cool. I like the panels. The Jimmy Neutron one was pretty cool.
Ron Paulson was there.
Yeah, Ron Paulson was there.
He was doing a lot of the voices.
He
did Yakko.
He did Yakko.
For a little bit. That was
pretty
cool.
He did Yakko.
Yeah.
Who else did he? He did Carl from Jimmy Neutron. Because it was the Jimmy Neutron reunion.
Right. So he was doing the
characters. Yeah. He was even like, because it was funny. One of the fans in the audience asked him, you know, how come when Jimmy goes to space, you know, he doesn't suffocate? And why doesn't he have a helmet? And, why doesn't that? I mean, do you guys think of that? Or is there some other thing that's going on with the thing? And then he's just like, sometimes you just go to space and it's a cartoon. You gotta remember, it's a cartoon.
Like, come on, kid.
Come on,
like,
kid.
Really?
You're reading too much into this. You have a fucking genius kid that has a toy or a robot dog.
Yep.
And that's what you're having a problem with?
Yeah.
That they can't breathe in space? Mm-hmm.
Where does he get the materials for his dog?
How is this possible?
See, how'd you miss all these other, takes, man? Yeah.
Yeah, exactly. Where is he getting the nuclear material, mind you, to develop these animals or these experiments? Doesn't make sense. Anyway. Yeah, that was pretty funny. But that one Mandy trailer, That the Mandy trailer. Yeah, the Mandy trailer looked pretty cool.
I have to check that out. That's been out. I understand it's on YouTube, but
YouTube Red, I think.
Yeah, some shit like that. So,
see, I was confused at first. I thought it was coming out because I hadn't seen it in any platform.
Yeah, mm-hmm.
But apparently it's on YouTube.
Yeah, I know. That's why I thought it was going to be in a movie theater or something.
Yeah, or limited release.
Or limited release or something.
We gotta look that up.
Yeah, but it was cool. Elijah Wood was there. Mm-hmm. I think he was closing it out, wasn't he?
Yeah, that was the last panel.
Yeah, so it was.
And
it was
Kevin Smith came on the big screen and had everybody say Excelsior to Stanley.
Yeah, since he couldn't make it. Yeah.
He's had a shitty fucking year, Stanley.
Oh, dude.
All these lawsuits and shit.
All these lawsuits, his wife dying.
Yeah, that wasn't good.
I think that was the beginning of the end for him.
He's 94.
Yeah, and he's still going.
He's still kicking right now.
So he's not in the best spot. But
anytime you know you have an opportunity to see Stan Lee, check him out before.
Yeah.
Before anything happens.
Definitely, definitely, please.
Well, Josh, you have any other kinds of nerd news there, man?
Oh yeah, man. We did take a little break from all of this. There was one little story I found quite amusing. So recently, or in the last month, Ryan Reynolds has been, openly criticizing Green Lantern like a lot more because there's been a lot more news as far as the backstory on what really happened on Green Lantern.
Oh, crazy. Okay.
So a fan posted a picture on Twitter, and it was a truck that had like a bunch of superheroes on it. And on the very back, it was Ryan Reynolds' Green Lantern. And so the fan sent it to him. He said, at Van City Reynolds, that's his Twitter handle, saw this and thought you would be thrilled, and then with the eye roll emoji. So then Ryan Reynolds responded, Josh Brolin can drive whatever the hell he likes. It's not for us to decide.
All right.
Yeah. So he was kind of poking fun, and then he, because recently in he came out in THR, The Hollywood Reporter, discussing what really happened, like, with Deadpool and Green Lantern. Mm-hmm. And I guess what he said was that originally they had come to him with Deadpool. And, they weren't sure if it was going to get greenlit, And so then he got the offer for Green Lantern. Mm-hmm. And so then when he went back to the guys for Deadpool, he's like, look, I will do this if this is going to happen. I'll turn down the other one if this is going to happen. But if this doesn't happen, then I'm going to go do Green Lantern. Mm-hmm. And they just said, it's not going to happen. So then he ended up going to do Green Lantern. And so then while he was doing it, a few of the writers went and met him while he was on set of Green Lantern. And they started writing the Deadpool movie. So as they were writing it, it was him, writers Rhett Reese, Paul Wernick. They flew to New Orleans. Mm-hmm. And while I was shooting Green Lantern, we were actually all together writing Deadpool. We were breaking the story of the original Deadpool movie in a house that was being paid for by Green Lantern's dime. And so he worried that, he wouldn't be allowed to play Deadpool, especially if Green Lantern was a hit.
Which it wasn't.
And then it wasn't. So that made it perfect for him to go into Deadpool, and then the rest is history.
Mm-hmm.
So on Ryan Reynolds' birthday on October 23rd, with all the ribbing and everything, the WB decided to post something in honor of Ryan Reynolds' birthday.
What did he say?
Hold on, let me bring it back up.
Is that why he was recently like in Italy or something? He was probably vacationing.
No, he's making a movie.
Oh, is he?
Yeah, he's making a movie. So this is what Warner Brothers put on their Twitter. In brightest day and blackest night, you won't want to ignore our party invite. Happy birthday at Van City Reynolds. And it's his picture of the Green Lantern.
Just so, like, hey, motherfucker.
Hey, motherfucker.
You wore this suit too.
Don't forget. You want to talk as much shit as you want, then here. We stamp this on you.
Take that.
Yeah, so I thought that was pretty funny.
Uh-huh.
But I mean, that's pretty much it right now. I suggest everyone go look up Henry Cavill, Witcher, testing footage.
Mm-hmm.
He looks badass in that.
Yeah.
I'll make sure to find it, see if I can post it on Facebook.
He does, however, in a regular picture that they just took of him, everybody's making fun of his wig.
Yeah, it looks too long. It looks it doesn't fit right on the standstill.
One of the best memes I've seen so far of that picture of him in the white wig. It was pretty much the picture, but it looked like an Amazon ad or like a Spirits Halloween costume ad where it says, get your Witcher costume with comes with the wig, you know, fucking a cloak or whatever the hell.
Henry Cavill not included.
Yeah, Henry Cavill not included because it looks so kind of like fake and campy. So, man, I'm sure it'll look good when it when the product is finished.
Yeah, I'm sure once it's done, it'll it'll look good. But there's actually, so there's one more thing I wanted to bring up. So for all you gamers out there, you know, speaking on Witcher, I found out there's a new little thing going on that Microsoft is promoting. It's called the Xbox All Access.
Oh shit.
So
what's that all about, eh?
So what it is get a new Xbox One console, over 100 games with Xbox Game Pass and online multiplayer Xbox Live Gold, all with no upfront costs and one low monthly price for 24 months. So essentially, you're pretty much paying off your system.
Yeah.
So you can start off for an Xbox One X starting at $34.99 a month.
Holy shit!
It includes all that shit together with it, so you don't have to pay for a separate membership anymore. So it includes the Xbox One X console, 24 months of Xbox Game Pass, and Xbox Live Gold, 0% APR for 24 months. So you're paying zero interest for all 24 months that you're paying this thing off.
Yeah.
And no upfront cost. So it all depends on if you qualify for the Powered by Dell preferred account. So they're probably going to run your credit and make sure you're not going to fucking just buy the shit in default or something.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, so... but it's pretty accessible. Everyone go on Microsoft.com if you're interested in it. All you got to do is you just got to apply to see if you qualify for a Dell preferred account to where they'll allow you to do payment plans. And if you do, then there you go. You just jump right in, choose your bundle, and then you can start playing your games that you want. And then they'll go and then they'll send you your Xbox.
Crazy.
Yeah, so you can get a brand new Xbox One X, 1 terabyte console.
Yeah.
And then you just pay $34.99 a month.
Wow.
Yeah, and you get all the games with it too.
That's pretty good. And that's what I'm doing with my Apple iPhone currently, where I'm doing that upgrade program where I don't give a whole lump sum. I'm just paying a monthly thing.
Yeah, and that's essentially what this is. Mm-hmm. It's like the upgrade program for your consoles. So I think the reason why they're doing this now is to lead you in so when the newer consoles come out, like the...
Just give you that.
Yeah, and then they're just like, okay, so now...
You grow with them.
You can grow with them. Instead, you can upgrade to this or that. Yeah. When I actually think that's better than paying upfront cost of like... Because like, when I first bought my Xbox, the first brand new one, it was like $4.99.
Yeah.
Now it's $2.99. Mm-hmm. At least if you're doing this, you're not going to be hit with depreciation and screwed trying to resell that shit.
True.
Because I had to resell mine for like only... $100. So I lost out $300 on my Xbox.
Right.
Yeah, so it's not worth it.
Well, I want to say that game consoles are lasting a lot longer these days, too. Yes. So it might be worth it.
Yeah, yeah. Definitely look it up. Look out, guys, because especially for those that can't really afford a console right up front.
Mm-hmm.
You know, there are a lot of people out there that, you know, don't have PS4s or Xboxes because it's like, dude, do I really want to drop $300 this weekend just for a console?
Right.
Like, I'm not going to be motivated to buy a game. And if I do, it's another $60 on top of that.
Are they $60 these days?
Just one brand new game, it's $60.
God damn.
And then, like, a week or two later, it depreciates all of a sudden to, like... like, if you resell it, it depreciates to, like, $19.
Yeah. Oh, man.
Yeah, it's fucking wrecked.
Do you remember the times of game codes when you didn't have to buy a downloadable content that cost like $29.99,
another $30?
You just had a code, and then you unlock the extra stuff.
Yeah, I remember that.
I miss that.
Looking up cheat codes.
Yeah.
Well, the internet changed the game.
Oh,
pardon the pun.
God damn it!
All right, well, listen.
All right, we're moving on.
Oh, son of a bitch! Okay, that was a good one. Fuck you guys. But it did. It literally changed the game. I mean, all these capabilities that you're able to do. In like every game kind of has its own little in-store, you know, where you can just buy shit for it.
And especially where now you can upload, you know, that they allow the capability to upload videos of the game being played. It's like enhanced it more. So like before, you know, you used to buy the strategy guides. You're like, okay, let me buy the strategy guide. I want to read up on that or see if I can get all the little stuff while playing the game.
Yeah.
Like, I know I did that when I played Kingdom Hearts 2 on the PS2.
Mm-hmm.
I had it and I fucking 100%ed that game by using that game guide.
Uh-huh.
But it's like nowadays you don't really need to do that. You could just watch a fucking YouTube video. And,
right, right.
Yeah, you know, so, yeah. Anyway.
Cool, man. I digress. All right. Was that going to do it for Nerd News?
That's going to do it for Nerd News.
All right, dude.
I'm going to go cry.
Yeah. Yeah, you will. Well, we'll be right back.
Hey, podcast listeners. Joe C. here. Are you digging all the music talk and want to see what my band, The Fallen Electric, has in store? Check us out at thefallenelectric.com for all news, show dates, and contact information. Also, be sure to listen to our album, Never Seen the World, available on all digital music stores and streaming apps. It's time to get electrified.
Let's just go and waste some time.
And we're back. What's up, Josh?
What's up, man?
Hey, you got some sports, man?
Yes, sir.
Here we go. Sports with Josh. What's up, man?
What's up, man?
Here, let me play something real quick.
Yeah, that's
very, very sad day.
Who died?
Well, Steph.
The National League.
The Dodgers. The Dodgers didn't win the World Series.
Oh, that's all right.
Fuck you.
Boston just had a better team.
They fucking raped us, dude.
Yeah.
Like, you know what? It was very heartbreaking hearing that Comic-Con, that Comic-Con recap, because there was so much hope in that, Josh. That Comic-Con Josh had hope that the Dodgers would do it, that would win the World Series.
I know. And we had just finished watching that really fucking long game.
Oh, I know.
While we were at Comic-Con, we went home and then saw them lose. And they lost the next day. And
it was so deflating. That deflated my weekend.
Yeah,
I was just like, oh, man, I don't want to do anything. I was so upset that I went and bought Taco Bell. That's how upset I was.
Yeah, we all bought Taco Bell that
night.
Yeah,
grilled stuff burrito.
Woo!
that's all you were happy about.
Yeah.
Well, I got that new chalupa, that $5 box.
Oh, that chalupa.
Oh, man, that'll fill you up.
Yep. But you know what? There's always next year, man.
Yeah, well,
isn't that what you say every year?
Shut up. That's all I got to say. Oh. I mean, there's, and we know it. We're in a lot of, there's like a lot of clout going on because no one really knows what's going to happen with this team. Kershaw possibly could leave.
Yeah.
Manny Machado could leave, which is fine.
Which is okay with me. Yeah, man, that guy did not come through at all.
That guy had no hustle, and he was a dirtbag. Like, first stepping on someone's fucking back heel twice.
He did it to two first basemen,
and then he kicked the heel of fucking, what's his name from, I don't even know his name, from the Brewers.
Oh, from the Brewers.
Yeah, it's like, dude, that was fucked up. I didn't like that at all. And then
he has a very punchable face.
Very much
so. That doesn't help.
Oh, dude, totally. I'm telling you, man. He looks like those,
I don't like the guy.
Like those homies at my high school that thought they were all tough shit. Yeah. You just want
it. It's like, come on, man. Just, you know, put it away.
It's like, bro, just chill, man. We're all trying to have a good time. Just relax.
Yeah.
And then a lot of the calls that Dave Roberts was making as to the bullpen were just questionable. Like, to bring out Ryan Matson, who had given up, you know, a home run or, you know, had given up runs in every single appearance.
Yep.
Every single appearance in the World Series. And not only that, even including in the National League Series.
Right.
The Championship Series.
Mm-hmm.
Like, it just didn't make sense. Same thing with Alex Wood. And for them to sit on their player like Pedro Baez, that was on fire, mind you, especially since we gave him a hard time in the beginning of the year.
Yeah, no, we didn't like him.
We didn't like him
one bit.
But he stepped up, man.
He did okay.
Yeah,
he did okay. I'm not mad at him.
No, I'm not. Him and Walker Buehler. Walker Buehler was up.
Buehler was a fucking champion.
Oh, dude, he's going to be our ace next year. He's going to be our ace.
Oh, yeah, he's
sure
our new star.
And then I don't know what the hell he was thinking keeping in Kike Hernandez in the entire starting lineup. The guy hit nothing. He had two hits in the entire series. And one of the hits, mind you, was a home run. But there was no reason for him to start him the next day when it was an elimination game. And he just hit it. It just didn't make any sense. Mm-hmm. So we'll see what they do with Roberts, because Roberts' contract is up as well. So, you know, there hasn't been any discussion as far as if there's going to be a contract extension to him or not.
I just don't like all this analytical shit that's going on, where they put more trust in the statistics and the numbers rather than just eyeballing it like they have been all these years. I know that these analytics have got them to the World Series, but obviously it's not playing out how they wanted it
to. Yeah, it's not. And there's examples on when you fully dive into analytics and just commit to it, you're going to fail. Like Billy Bean, the guy who invented all of this, who invented Moneyball.
Yeah.
He never won a World Series. Mm-hmm. He never won because he devoted, and he was just so devoted to analytics. It had to stay the route. Whereas you have teams like the Boston Red Sox, who their GM, Dave Dombrowski, he uses analytics, but he uses the old ways. It's like, all right, I trust my manager. He knows what to do, you know, what our game plan is, but if his eyes see something else, then he can change it. It'll give him the decision.
Yeah, because there's human error all the time.
Yeah, and in the Dodgers' case, Dave Roberts was just the puppet. He's just towing the company line. That's pretty much what it was. So we'll see. We'll see what happens. There has been talks that our GM, Farhan Zaidi, one of the analytics guys, may leave to the Giants.
Oh, crazy.
And become the president of baseball operations for the Giants.
Oh, wow.
So, you know, I'll update everyone more as, you know, we'll get more news on what's happening with the entire team right now. There's still not much going on. You know, everyone's just kind of in mourning, at least, Dodgers-wise.
Yeah, Boston's having a ball.
But... Oh, dude, they're fucking partying. Someone actually threw a beer at the head of the manager.
Oh, shit.
Alex Cora.
Yeah.
Yeah, and they got arrested him immediately. During the parade today. Yeah, it was nuts.
Fucking Boston.
So I'm going to finish off sports with a little recap of our picks from last week.
Yeah, so, NFL picks. Where are we all at, man? So we got Steph, you, the Foo, and me.
Yes.
And it's been an interesting couple last week. So what do we got?
So last week, the Foo was 3-4. He got the Lions, the Bucks, the Vikings, and the Ravens games wrong. I was 5-2. I got the Ravens and the Giants game wrong.
All right.
Josie was 6-1.
Yeah, boy.
And what? You only got the Ravens game wrong.
Yeah, yeah.
And then Steph was 4-3. You got the Giants, Ravens, the Vikings, and I'm missing. Yeah, Giants, Ravens, Vikings game wrong.
It was that damn Ravens game.
Yep, that Ravens game fucked all of us.
Yeah, it fucked all of us up.
So right now, as the standings go, the Foo is 18-12.
Uh-huh.
Steph is 17-13.
How's the Foo beating me?
I know, right? Well, because he had a pretty good, picks the week previously. He caught up. He caught up. Josie is 19-11.
Woo!
And I am 20-10.
Oh, you bitch!
Yeah, that's right, motherfuckers. God damn it!
Well,
I know.
Giddy up.
So we'll get the picks on the next podcast. So I just kind of wanted to give everyone a recap. Some of the games that I'll be talking on next podcast, talking about next podcast, are Jets Dolphins, so you guys can marinate. Steelers Ravens, Lions Vikings, Falcons Redskins, Texans versus Broncos, and then Chargers versus Seahawks. And then the last game is actually Rams versus Saints.
Man, the Rams have been. They've been insane.
They have been insane.
They've been so insane.
Yeah, but you know what? This is going to be a close game with the Saints because the Saints are really good.
Yeah.
Their offense is good. So every game's really close line. I'll give everyone the lines on Thursday. Just go ahead and think about what you may want to pick.
Yep.
Then we'll get back to it on Thursday.
Right on, man. Is that it for sports?
That's it for sports.
All right. Well, today, October 31st, we record our 50th episode, everyone. Yeah.
On Halloween.
On Halloween. Huh. So, on Halloween, we got this very breaking, awesome news. So, here's another joint report.
Are you on weed? Give me some. I'll smoke you two under the table.
Well, we we've been seeing a lot of cannabis legalization all throughout the world, most recently with Canada. Today, just a little couple hours ago, Mexico City drug policy reformers claimed victory in Mexico City Wednesday after the country's Supreme Court handed down two rulings legalizing cannabis for all forms of non-commercial adult use.
Gasp!
I know. So it's happening. It's happening in North America, like, for sure. Like, we're going to be the dicks in between who still haven't gotten our shit together.
Seriously.
And have ruled this, you know, a legal, safe thing that
come
we
on,
can
man.
Consume.
Come on, America, Mexico, freaking America's pants and top hat are beating us out.
Yeah.
You're gonna be like that sober guy at the party that just sits around everybody that's smoking. Just like,
you know, that's bad for your health, right?
Fucking Daria shows up. That's us. That's America. Well, I'm here to say that.
That's not America. That's not even Mexico.
I mean, it's
it
not.
Isn't. It isn't.
It literally isn't.
It literally isn't. Oh my God. Oh my God. That all makes sense now.
Yeah.
That's dope though, because I also heard too that there's a country in Asia that's also planning on legalizing marijuana. I can't recall which one it is. I believe it was like either Indonesia or Thailand was planning on legalizing recreational marijuana.
Crazy.
Yeah, so it's starting to become
a thing
worldwide.
Yeah,
so,
for sure.
I mean, hopefully it catches on.
Did you hear about the story? If you, for South Korean citizens, if they go to Canada and smoke weed and come back and they test positive, they can actually be fined.
Oh,
yeah,
what
they can
the
get in trouble.
So they can't do it on vacation.
Yeah, that sucks.
Yeah.
Dang, that fucking blows.
They're just like, okay, no, it's legal over there, but don't do it.
Right.
Don't you dare.
I guess in their view, it's like, don't bring THC of any kind in anything to our country, kind
even
of thing.
Even yourselves.
Crazy, right?
Yeah, man.
They could be fined up to like $5,000.
Holy shit.
Yeah, it's crazy.
No, thank you. Dude, was that eighth worth it? Was that $30 eighth worth that $5,000?
No.
Never know.
Well, I'm sure we're going to see more develop and what comes out of this and how soon they're actually going to implement the legalization, how it's going to be commercialized out there and how it's going to be taxed. So,
prediction.
Yeah.
2020 ballot, legalization of marijuana will be on that ballot.
And then we're good to go.
And then we're good to go.
Yeah. I think I see it coming too.
Yeah.
We just weren't first this time, you know?
It's okay, but though. I'd rather be third, I guess.
In North America.
Yeah.
Well, unless Greenland beats us
oh,
to it.
Oh, son of a bitch. Greenland.
Yeah, I know, right? Anyway, well, that was the joint report.
Smoke weed every day.
Excuse me.
Well, last and definitely not least segment of the day, the music segment. Rock and roll! I want to rock! Well, Eargasm. Eargasm high-fidelity earplugs already trusted by 100,000 customers and growing. Enjoy your favorite activities without worrying about damage to your ears. Keep the noise to a minimum, but still hear people talking and hear music with clarity. Discreet design, and it comes with a lightweight aluminum case for easy transport. Click through the banner at foobarshow.com to get yours and help support the show. Eargasm. Put it in your ear.
Put it in your ear.
Yeah. So today, as we're recording this, again, it is Halloween. It is our 50th episode. Here's to 50 more. We'll see where this goes.
We'll see.
Yeah. But we brought out a few highlights. And me and Josh are talking when we're just like, what are the best or the better Halloween songs that are out there right now?
Yeah.
Halloween spooks.
No, Hollywood speaks. One of them that rings true to a lot of a lot of Generation Xers. This one came out in 1995 by the Misfits. Collection 2 is where I tend to listen to this one when I do, and this one is just called Halloween.
Oh,
You ever heard this one, Josh?
No, I haven't actually.
Oh, really? No, oh, interesting. Yeah, I mean, you talk to any Mitzvitz fan, they'll be blaring this out of their 98 fucking Civic.
Hatchback.
Hatchback. That they inherited or something. And they'll be blaring this, you know, as they're driving by your house at, around this time of the year.
Yeah, huh,
for sure.
That's the perfect description. I know quite a few people that fit that description.
Well, fucking this next one, and you know, you don't really think about this one, but it's totally a Halloween song. Oingo Boingo's Dead Man's Party.
Huh.
1982's Oingo Boingo's Dead Man's Party.
Let me get this straight. Uh-huh. You picked an 80s song.
I picked an 80s song because you know what, man? It's not as annoying. Yeah, well, you've heard this one, obviously. Steph?
I heard it like 3 times today.
Yeah, if you're just listening to the regular radio.
On the way to and from work.
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah, they're playing this all day long. Good old Danny Elfman. Fun fact for those who don't know, he's also the writer of the Simpsons theme.
Yeah, that's
he
right.
He came up with that.
He was the composer of the original Batman score of the 1989 Tim Burton movie.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Anything really Tim Burton, he's
pretty much
all about it.
Nightmare Before Christmas.
Yes, he
sure did.
And you hang on with that thought. But this next song, this next song is one that everybody really just cannot not talk about in Halloween time. It's fucking Michael Jackson's Thriller.
Oh, yeah.
And then you do the dance, and then everybody's happy.
I mean,
that's as much as we go. Yeah,
and then you get Vincent Price just saying some shit to you.
This
at the
is
end.
A great hit, but I have to
it's
say,
fluffed out, right?
That played out.
Party City killed it.
Oh,
their commercials
I know.
Every single year, and their shitty costumes.
Yep. Yeah, it's terrible. Terrible.
But I mean, it holds up.
The song's a good song.
It holds up. It's just fucked up.
Yeah, it's just they use it in fucked up ways.
Yeah.
Why they gotta ruin a good song, man?
These last two that I wanted to bring up too is this one. I really don't have it on my rotation, but every time it comes on the radio, and it's usually around this time of the year, not Halloween Spooks, but 1998's Rob Zombie's Living Dead Girl.
Who is this irresistible creature who has an insatiable love for the dead?
This is a fun one to listen to, and it's really fun. Electronic too. So like, it'll sound badass in a speaker system.
Oh hell yeah!
A lot of bass.
I have this entire album. I listened to it on repeat when I first got it.
Oh my god!
Nonstop.
Yeah. Oh man, I remember being a kid and my dad taking me to the batting cages for baseball practice.
Yeah.
And my dad was just blasting this in the car, and then I'm just sitting there like,
you gotta get pumped. Yeah.
Yeah. So this was pretty solid. Now, this last one, speaking of Danny Elfman from a little earlier in the segment, I mean, it's the song from fucking The Nightmare Before Christmas. What do you say, Josh?
Yes.
Yeah, this one's fucking solid.
Oh, hell yeah.
Hello,
girls of every age, wouldn't you like to see something strange?
Come with us and you will see. This our town of Halloween. This is Halloween, this is Halloween. Pumpkins scream in the dead of night. This is Halloween, everybody make a scene. Trick or treat, tell the neighbors on the diaphragm. It's our town, everybody's free.
Yeah, you can't knock this one. This is the best one ever,
yeah.
I think,
yeah,
made about Halloween.
Didn't we learn about Danny Elfman in the history of rock and roll? And I remember vaguely our professor saying that he doesn't read sheet music. He just hums the song.
Yes. Uh-huh. And so he has like a ghostwriter writing it all down for him.
Yeah. Yeah. I think I took that same class at Citrus.
Yeah.
Yep. Yeah, yeah, I took that after you guys. Yep. But yeah, obviously he sings the parts for Jack. And he plays the voice of Jack on The Night Before Christmas. So, yeah, he's a fucking super talented
The fucking guy from Oingo Boingo is Jack Skellington. And every year he does this thing over at the Hollywood Bowl, or at least he has been doing it for the last few years, where he has an entire orchestra while they're playing the visuals of the movie on a big screen.
They're pretty much, you're watching the big screen to a live orchestra.
Uh-huh.
They've done it for, I think they did it for Star Wars.
Yep.
There was another movie where he did it for, I believe it was, they did it for Lion King 2.
Mm-hmm.
They have it for a lot of the Disney movies, and then I think a few Star Wars, and Indiana Jones was one of them too, I think.
Sweet.
Yeah, so it's pretty cool. Check those out, guys, if you see it. Check out SeatGeek. They may have it.
Yeah, man. Well, damn, dude, 50 fucking episodes, what do you say? You were only a part of the last 30, though, right?
Yeah.
Because the Foo was my sidekick from the beginning, but now he's off doing his
foolishness.
His all his foolishness, of course.
Patent pending.
But yeah. Steph, anything you want to say about the 50 episodes so far?
Congratulations, you guys. I mean, 50 episodes is 50. Pretty hard to get to.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So
we're just dumping them out.
It's all about consistency.
Just give me some cheese, I'll dump out 50 more.
Oh, geez. Oh,
wait, what?
Oh, man.
Oh, I didn't want to end it that way.
Well, thank you all very much for listening into the Foo Bar Show. Thank you for downloading the pod on most major podcast apps, subscribing, and telling a friend like a champ. You can always reach us at Foo Bar Show. That's FOOBarShow.com. And FOOBarShow is our handle on Facebook, Tumblr, Twitter, and Instagram. Check us out. Drop us a line and we'll fill it up like a couple of foos. Ah. I've been Josie.
I've been Josh.
And for Steph, an honorable mention to the Foo, saying, don't be a dick.